Hello, everybody. Welcome to a brand new episode of the Southern Fried Philosophy Podcast. It's two guys' take on life, liberty, and the pursuit of gravy, and you, the listener, are getting a degree in common sense. We are broadcasting live from the HB5 studios right here in beautiful downtown historic Concord, North Carolina. We've got a great show lined up for you. As always, I will be your co-host, Biggun, and the second half of this crazy sideshow I'm going to bring in is the pride of Anderson, South Carolina, 2016's Honorable Mention Father of the Year, the inventor of the redneck egg roll. Give it up for my man, our old Mike number one, it's Mojo!
I don't even know who this is.
You don't remember Grits?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Girls Raised in the South. No, just kidding. It's like a 90s Christian rap band, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's right. Good call.
Some Grits, man.
Good call. Welcome back. This is the start off of a brand new year, 2017. This is what, episode 19?
19.
Wow. I remember 19. But anyway, episode 19, you guys can find us on Facebook at Southern Fried Philosophy. You can find us at Instagram, Twitters, and SFP Radio. And also, SouthernFriedPhilosophy.com is up
there
and
is.
Go. We started off 2017 with it. Something new. That was our New Year's resolution, right?
It was something that we needed to get done in a year, and so we finally
was less than a year.
Able to do it.
Yeah, it was less
than a year. We got it done.
Like 5 months, four and a half, something
nailed
like that.
It.
Something like that. Today's episode, we have, let's see what we got upcoming. How you be doing?
As always.
2016 recap, maybe some worst or best highlights that we mm-hmm. can kind of come up with. Also, that time of the month, it's not what you think.
Oh, buddy.
And also, I'm going to kind of just kind of mention our guest right now, just in case mm-hmm. she wants to offer any insight or whatever. But we have our special guest today, Megan Johnson. I'll kind of give her more of a formal introduction a little bit later mm-hmm. in the show. But Megan Johnson, how are you doing?
I'm doing great. How's it going?
Doing great. Thanks for stopping in today of the show, the first show of the new year. So
you bet.
You're kicking off 2017 with a bang.
That's right. So, Biggun, how you be doing?
Man, I'm good. Oh, fresh off of like 80 days off of work, so that's been great.
it felt like that, man.
It was awesome. Get some time to relax. You know, we went down to the in-laws for their Christmas vacation.
I'm sorry.
So here's the deal. Like, I was thinking about that during the Christmas break. And, you know, most people are saying, you know, I don't like my mother-in-law. Like, we've got issues. Like, you've mentioned several times, you don't like your mother-in-law.
Lighthearted. No, we like each other. It's just, just like scouring pad versus scouring pad sometimes.
I don't know what that means, but all right.
Very abrasive.
But I actually have a really good relationship with my mother-in-law, so I feel bad. Like, you know. I hear you saying all the bad things, but I actually love my mother-in-law. So we have a great time.
And just in case my mother-in-law is listening, I don't say a lot of bad
stuff. No, he doesn't. It's just, you know.
Not on air.
So we spent some time there and got to hang out with Jessica's nieces, and gosh, they're just adorable. And then we headed down and went to Jacksonville and had a good time with my dad. Got to
saw you posting some pics from favorite eateries there.
Yes. Yeah. Golly. Can I tell you that Singleton's, that shrimp?
Tell me about the Singleton's. Is that like a little
It's a hole in the wall, like right
that's
off
the best
the,
places.
Right off of the like the intercoastal. And every morning they bring in a fresh
fish.
Catch of fish and shrimp and
so fresh
and
off the boat.
Mm-hmm. Gotcha. Yeah. And you can taste like the you know, the salt water, you mm-hmm. can taste the oil, you mm-hmm. know, from, you know, all the leaks and stuff like that. You can taste the trash. So that's always good.
Yeah,
you know it's fresh when you can taste the trash.
It's like a dumpster fish.
Yeah.
There you go.
And then got to go to the Tax Slayer Bowl. So I was really excited about that. I know you were upset that I blew up the Instagram, Facebook, Kentucky stuff.
I just don't want people to get, like, hating us.
Well, that's...
I mean...
But you're going to bring them back in with the Duke stuff,
true.
So...
That's true. I mean, but it could be worse. You could be a Bama fan.
Roll Tide.
Oh, my
Yellow
gosh.
Hammer, Roll
I don't know what's more annoying because I grew up near Clemson, not a Clemson fan. But if they win the national championship, we'll never hear the end of it for the next 20 years because the last one they won was 81. They still claim. I still people see it around with the tags that say, you know, national champs 1981.
Right. But it's like annoying as seeing people with those Dukakis stickers. You know, vote Dukakis. You know, like, guys, your time has passed.
Yeah, I think you need to go to the car wash and get that taken off. But, you know, but Alabama fans are just as annoying, man. You're going to get to hear that. I mean, but the coach is awesome there. So yeah. maybe we'll see. It should be an epic battle.
Yeah, it should be.
You went down to Jacksonville, visited, and how's the pops? Did he get his place finally sold?
Finally sold. Yes, awesome. Sir. He's coming up this week.
So no more slumlord.
No. He's upgraded to like semi-slumlord. Okay. No, it's a really good place. I'm really happy. That's awesome.
He's here now.
He's coming up next week to close on the place up here. So, awesome. Yeah,
really so we might see more of him in church and maybe family meal night.
No.
I'm gonna drag him there. I'm gonna drag him. I like old Papa Biggin.
Yeah. We could have a segment chatting with Cliffy.
We could have him and Leif on here.
Oh,
that'd be yeah. That might be a 5-hour show.
It would derail quickly.
Not like your pops. He's awesome.
Yeah, well, I'm glad
you might be the only. I might be the only one.
No, he's awesome. But we did get to go to Tax Slayer Ball, listen to KSR, tweeted a couple of things about that. And one thing I did want to bring up is we did got, that's Southern.
Yeah.
We got retweeted by Jay Billis. Right. So I thought that was really cool.
That is awesome.
So, really cool. And then, some of the KSR guys said that they'll be on the show. So we're excited about
KSR is Kentucky Sports Radio.
Yep.
Why would you have a whole station dedicated to Kentucky sports? But I don't know, but listen, hey, that's awesome. We'll take it.
It's awesome. And they literally are like some of the top listeners on iHeart just for a state, you know,
radio.
State sports radio.
Kentucky sports is kind of a religion.
Yes, it is. So, amen. I'll pray to that God any day.
So, how was the Tax Slayer Bowl? I mean,
you know, it was a good experience to go. Obviously, we got our butts beat, but you know, it was a cool venue.
What was it? Is that Jacksonville?
Mm-hmm. Okay. Yeah, it doesn't have a bad seat in the house. We bought as cheap tickets as we possibly could.
Is that the Jaguar Stadium?
Mm-hmm. Okay. Yeah. Everbank, I think it is.
Okay.
Super easy to get in and out of. Wow. Just to go see a show or a game is awesome.
Cool.
Yeah, no bad seat in the house.
Cool. I'm glad you guys spent so much time visiting, because I mean, it was actually kind of cool seeing all the places. You know, as a chef and a foodie man, I love restaurants, so I got singleness down on my list whenever I make it down to Jacksonville.
I got
a
couple more spots for you.
Awesome. So can't wait to hear that.
Check it out. What about you? How you been doing?
Well, I can't even remember the last time we saw each other, but
I think it was the birthday bash.
Probably. I don't even know. But no, we had a good holiday. The Christmas is a little more tame than our Thanksgiving because, you know, we did a kind of a transient Thanksgiving.
Sure.
So
yeah,
we had quite a few people there, but
you told all those people to stay home. I ain't doing that again.
No, I think Christmas is that one holiday that people do try to make the extra step home,
right?
To see their loved ones, or whatever. A lot of times, Thanksgiving, people have to work the next day, so we were blessed by Thanksgiving. We were blessed to have, I can't remember, 30, 40 people show up.
Holy cow!
Christmas, we just had actually just one of our friends over, Miss Monique. So if she's listening, she came over and enjoyed some prime rib, and we had a good old time, and then the news station caught word of a Facebook post I made. So they came out and did an interview with me on that. Yeah. So
I'm really kind of sad you didn't wear like an SFP shirt or like give a shout
out. Well, we got to get those. So, but no, they came and did that. You know, and the reason why I did that, I'm not one to try to bring glory to myself or the, you know, limelight, because I'm a very private person. But, the Facebook post I made was for my heart donor's family, because I mean, I cannot imagine, first Christmas without their loved one. So I just want to make sure that they know, if they happen to hear, share, whatever, that I'm so thankful for the kid that they raised that turned into be a man of purpose. So I just want to make sure they knew that. And like I said, I didn't ask for the news coverage, but I was glad for the extra push. Yeah. I mean, so just in very case cool. It does get out there, but that was pretty cool. But other than that, you know, just we travel, you know, too, and went and saw my parents, and then we, of course, went and saw the in-laws. actually, I didn't. I'm taking it back. My wife and kids went and saw the in-laws. I stayed home because we have a dog, and I somehow forgot to book a boarding house. So
I see those air quotes.
Yeah, yeah.
You forgot to book a boarding house.
So I got to stay home for a few days. It was kind of nice.
Isn't it nice?
Yeah.
I got back from that, and I'm an introvert, actually, you know, deep down in the core. And I got back, and I was just like, I've been around people for like 12 days straight, and I'm like about to kill somebody.
Beanbags and tidy whities, man, I'm telling you.
So this was the first day my wife went into the office, and I stayed home, and I just was like quiet, and I was just like, oh, this sounds so good.
This is kind of nice. You hear an echo.
Yeah. So that was good. Yeah. And so that was our holiday recap. Let's recap 2016. What are some things that that you don't want to see move on to 2017, or some things that...
I don't think we have enough time for the show. I think some of the worst things that happened in 2016 was a libertarian, Gary Johnson. What a joke. We're going to have Jeremy back on, our resident libertarian specialist. He'll be back on pretty soon. But Gary Johnson was a pretty big embarrassment for 2016 for the Libertarian Party. We actually had a huge opportunity to push forth.
To get a whole whopping 3%.
Yeah. I mean, actually pretty good.
Yeah.
But he could have done so much better if it wouldn't have been Gary Johnson. So, but he's become the source of so many memes, you know, with what's Aleppo and sticking his tongue out during a report. I mean, just stupid stuff. But
I think a trash bag could have done better. I'm just saying.
Probably so. Probably so. The death of political correctness. I would like to see that happen in 2017.
You think Trump could actually do that?
Yeah, well, I mean, I don't know. If he does do that, then that'll be one good thing he's actually done.
Oh, my
but,
gosh.
But, you know, political correctness has led to so many other things. I mean, it's really hurting your free speech because, and I'm not saying you go out and just belligerently belittle someone, because I've never been for that, but now we have to worry about safe spaces. We have to worry about... The word racist has been overused now. It has lost its meaning because everyone, if you don't get your way, that person is racist. The other terms like systematic has been used. I think that's probably, if I had a nickel for every time I heard systematic, I mean, you know what I'm saying? That's just, that word's been overplayed.
Right.
I know sometimes we've had discussions about white privilege. You know, I would like to see that kind of, that term and ideology go away just because they're very polarizing issues. You know, it puts people into two different boats. I'd kind of like to see us all back in the same boat because guess what? We all bleed. We all can all share the same organs. Obviously, I'm a walking testimony of that, but we all bleed blood. I mean, we all have to live in this country together. So let's just stop the things that kind of really hurt us. But the best things came out of 2016. I'm alive. I mean, so that's pretty cool.
So you went through all the list of the things that you don't like on 2016. I wrote on my list the dab and the water bottle flip. That's how we're so different. Looks so intense, and I'm like, I don't want to see that dab thing. That's kind of annoying.
Well, I did post that picture on our Facebook.
Right.
The dab. I can't tell you how many times my 13-year-old has done the dab. Sometimes I just want to, like, come up to her like Larry Moe and Curly and just do the fingers in her eyes when she does that. So,
you know, dab spelled backwards. I'm just
bad.
Saying.
How about that? Mm. Megan, did any of your kids do the dab?
Mason loves the dab. Can't get enough.
Yeah.
Is he doing it's gone cross country, you know. Yeah. It's not just North Carolina.
Oh, no. It's all over the place. Yeah. Does he do the water bottle flip thing now?
Does not. No? He's too busy doing the dab.
What if he did the water bottle flip, then dabbed if he got it?
That's a big thing, too.
Yes. He can bounce a ball and eat some blueberries at the same time, so maybe.
Whoa. Maybe that'll be a thing in 2017.
Yeah.
Bounce a ball and eat blueberries.
The basketball blueberry challenge hashtag. Yeah, there we go.
He's six, by the way.
I don't think I could do
nothing
that.
Nothing too challenging.
To be honest with you.
I could barely rub my tummy and pat my head at the same time. So,
the mannequin challenge. That's ridiculous.
Yeah. Thank God that quickly came and quickly went. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Not like the ice bucket challenge, which I know was good for a good purpose, but that thing lasted way too long. Yeah. So, what else you got?
Oh, that was it. Those are the things I'm glad to see Rio.
How about man buns?
Man buns.
Yes.
Yes.
I personally would offer a bounty. Like, I can't announce a dollar figure because that'd probably go broke pretty quick. But
well, we only
every
have
time
like
you
36
see,
yeah. listeners, so it's
shut up. We got a lot more than that. But if you saw a man bun in public, just chop it off.
It would be like the modern day Indian scalping, basically. It's a free run. Just
I'm not against that. So what do you think of the man bun, Megan?
Not a fan.
As a woman,
that's easy.
It's like, that's not attractive. It's
not so much.
I saw one today in Chick-fil-A line. Mm. Yeah. And I don't know. Just can't do that. But
yeah. Side note, things that burn my biscuits from 2016. I saw another, went again to Home Depot and saw three other dogs. And then while we were in Jacksonville, we saw a woman bring in two dogs. And the sign on the front said, service animals only. And then she looked at somebody and said, what? I can't bring them in. It's 57 degrees outside, they may get cold. Can I just say that?
Well, at least she's 57 thinking. Degrees. Maybe she was the service animal. Whether their dogs were walking her.
You know that's a thing, though. They do that at Home Depot. I think at Lowe's, too. Dogs just come in.
Oh, yeah. Like they shouldn't be. A dog doesn't need to build his own house.
Well, they're just not set. They're just not set up to handle the
The messes. It dropped a deuce right when I walked in, and
that's a problem.
Don't bring your dog into there.
Take him to PetSmart or PetSmart,
whichever one you think it is,
or the other one, Petco.
So sorry, that was a tangent, but it just it got to
it
me.
It does
again.
That does burn? Yeah.
Yeah.
But thank goodness, hopefully the man bun goes away in 2017 because that's just. That was very annoying seeing everybody pop up with those. And
I am glad about no more political ads, at least for another 4 years. So
or two.
Or two. Yeah.
But, you know, hey, I think 2017 is going to probably be interesting. Cause, I mean,
it'll be interesting. We've got
a few more days until we have a new president, so we should see what that that causes or happens.
You think he's going to get sworn in? Or something's going to happen between now and then.
Oh, God.
I'm just saying.
I don't want the Secret Service coming to us. You know, no, I think he'll be sworn in. I know that I read the other day that they're taking a shortened parade route.
Oh, sure they did.
Yeah.
Sure they did.
They're changing up inauguration a little bit different. Mm-hmm. So instead of Hair Obama. So because Obama, you know, so loved and, you know, he'd walk the parade route and everything like that. So, but Trump being a very controversial figure, so they modified that.
Here's my thought on that. They should have him, like, on the parade route, have him and then Kanye walking beside each other. Because if you're going to take a shot, you don't know which one you want to take a shot at. Which one do you want to kill
probably,
more?
Actually,
Kanye
How about we just, like, make a circle of people? That way.
Oh, yeah.
I mean, there's probably at least 10 or 12 people that, you know, I'm sure we could probably use his body protection, human shield. So
speaking about people dying, 2016 knocked off some big people, huh?
Yeah, I think 168, I think. But I mean, if you counted some subgenres of music, I think it was like 316 people that passed away that were quote-unquote celebrities.
Know the Clintons or something? What's going on with that?
I don't know if you saw I know this is insensitive. I'm a Carrie Fisher fan too, but I don't know if you saw the tweet, the spoof tweet of Carrie Fisher.
I have not.
It said, I have some damning information on Hillary Clinton. and then had another retweet. Of course, she passed away. And had another retweet that says, if something happens to me, I've passed it to my mother, Debbie.
Oh, no.
So that happened. But anyway, very insistent jokes. Please don't email me. The lack of political correctness. The lack of political correctness is in 2016. So, thank goodness to all the political crap.
Yep.
You know, I'm sure now we'll just hear 4 years of how bad Trump is. And
now
at least we don't have to hear from two different parties now. Right. You know, but anyway.
So 2017 should be good. I will miss all the Rio stuff that went down in Rio. That was classic.
But hey, you know what? 2016, personally, for me, was great.
Oh, yeah.
So I have no complaints. I mean, I know that. You know, people have had sadness and loss and things like that. But, you know, that's one reason why I wanted to have Megan on the show today was to, you know, maybe show how we can, by the way, Megan is a psychologist, but, you know, maybe setting us up mentally on how to cope and also have a positive outlook. I mean, because I think it's all mental there, you know, I mean, because for people to, you know, after the election, having to have safe spaces where they brought puppies and Play-Doh in and game day and pizza and things like that for Yale college students or other college.
You didn't have to go to class or take tests because of the presidential election. Yeah, that was great.
I feel bad for our country if these are the people that are defending our country. But you know what I'm saying? There's a way to get through these things. And I think having a positive frame of mind is a big deal. So, but what else you got?
Well, I think for me, for 2016, was a good year. I think, you know, the launch of SFP and the show, I'm really excited about
that. Not to mention I'm alive. So.
And you're alive. Yeah.
That's a good thing.
Personally. I'm kind of digging that. Yeah. So, yeah.
Breathing's good, huh?
This side of the dirt. That's right. So I'm all good with that.
Very cool. You got anything else?
No. Just about time to do our next segment, buddy.
Let's roll into that time of the month. The tears are flowing. They're coming once again. And I'm starting fights that I just can't win. Why do I try? I never can tell. This time of the month, though it's sure right, so can you tell our listeners what that time of the month is?
That time of the month is that special time of the month where your wife gets all mean. And,
That's usually about every other day
for my wife. That time of the month is those wacky, crazy Hallmark, okay, maybe not so much Hallmark special holidays.
Yeah,
that are just kind of weird and weird and stupid, to be honest with you. In fact, I looked up today on how to try to get on one of these lists.
Yeah.
Just because, I mean, hey, yeah. I got like a wear your stinky socks day. I mean, come
yeah.
on. So.
Yeah. So how did you figure it out?
Not yet.
Okay.
I'm sure. $10 maybe we need to start a petition with the White House so they have to officially respond or something.
So. Well, you need more than 35 to signature to get that.
I'll go around door to door. I'm committed to this.
So that time of the month. So here's their monthly observances. And I think it kind of fits, you know, for New Year's. Get a balanced month. Get a balanced life month. Get organized month. But then there's some weird ones like adopt a rescued bird month. Mm-hmm. Birth defects month. I don't know why that's
birth
in there.
Defects month?
Yeah, I guess.
So it's like...
You want it? I don't know what that is about.
It's like so anti-March of Dimes.
California dried plum digestive month. Just in case, if you need that.
So prunes.
Oh, golly. These are just insane. Clean up your computer month. I don't know.
That's like if you're on Windows version 7 or something.
Mail order gardening month. How exactly does that work? Mail order gardening. I guess you order some seeds or something like
you
that?
Or your bulbs.
Mm. Yeah. It is polka music month and stalking awareness month. Now, listen, if I could get a stalker.
Stalking or stalking?
Stalker.
Oh, stalker.
Yeah, stalking awareness month. So I would love to have a stalker.
I wouldn't be offended.
I think it'd be kind of fun. And it's oatmeal month, so that's good. So those are some monthly observances. Do you have any?
Let's see. Upcoming this week, mm-hmm. Bubble Bath Day. Actually, today, which is, this is actually Tuesday. Of course, our show won't air until later, but today was like Festival Sleep Day.
Was it really?
Yeah, I don't know how you'd party with that, but let's see. We have Bubble Bath Day coming up on Sunday
this
week.
That sounds awesome.
Yeah, National Rubber Ducky Day.
Mm-hmm.
National Dress Up Your Pet Day.
I hate that. I can't stand that.
People yeah, and of course, Tuesday, January 17th will be probably the slowest day in any gym. It's called National Ditch Your New Year's Resolution Day. So,
I'm a fan of that one.
Yeah, so I think everyone, yeah, that's probably on average, that's probably how long New Year's resolutions happen.
Listen, I make it the 17th, that's awesome. I consider that a win.
Beer Can Appreciation Day. I can appreciate that.
Mm-hmm.
National Opposite Day. I think 2016 was Opposite Day every day.
Yeah,
so,
right?
Yeah.
So that's the official day when you say it's Opposite Day.
Yeah.
It's the official day. Okay.
Yeah. I wonder who started that.
I did.
And this is the Fun at Work Day. We're always having fun.
Mm-hmm.
And Inspire Your Heart with Art Day is the last day of the month. So that's about all the ones I really kind of saw that stood out to me this month. Mm-hmm. But, yeah, so go out there and make sure you custom make that Hallmark card and give it to your special loved one. So
for oatmeal month.
And stalker. Yeah.
All right, well, that was that time of the month. When we come back, we are going to talk with our special guest, Megan Johnson. And if you know me, Biggun at all, you know I'm crazy about Kentucky and bourbon. So what happens when you throw coffee beans in a bourbon barrel? It's pure magic. I stumbled upon Kentucky Nose Bourbon Barrel Coffee a few years ago during a trip to Lexington, and it was love at first sip. From the heart of a true craftsman comes this unique combination of coffee and bourbon. Do yourself a favor and check out Kentucky Nose, KNOWS.com, to get the finest bourbon barrel coffee the bluegrass has to offer. That's KentuckyNose.com. And you can check them out on our sponsors link on our website.
Welcome back to the Southern Fried Philosophy Podcast. This is Mojo. This episode's guest is Megan Johnson. She is a psychologist. She can kind of tell you what's wrong with you. Her website is actually wellnesssolutionspllc.com. She's got a bunch of abbreviations at the end of her name, which I don't even know what they really mean. But you know what?
It looks like the alphabet, to be honest.
I can tell you right now, she was certified by Psychology today.
Just verified today.
Verified. Evidently, it verifies every day. Maybe. I don't know. Maybe they skip. Maybe they skip certain days. I don't know. They verify every day they end in Y. So.
That's every day.
Yeah. Okay. There you go. Okay.
Got it.
Sorry.
I'm with you.
But let's see if we can give you some snippets about Miss Megan here. And the reason why we wanted to have her on the show is just kind of, like I said, 2017. 2016 kind of wore on everyone. The closer it got, you start seeing these social memes like, 2016, I wish you would die, things like that.
Just, well, a lot of people did.
Yeah, a lot of people.
They just said, I'm done with this year.
That's right. They're
checking
done.
Out.
They're done with it. But, just kind of maybe starting out this year with a fresh kind of set of mindset, goals. And anyway, we want to bring her on for that. Megan was born in New Jersey.
Jersey.
I think you said Gillette, which is, I guess, where they make Gillette razors.
Maybe.
Or not.
Yeah.
Facts are optional, by the way.
Evidently, she was a rock star. She traveled around the world. Okay, maybe not a rock star. But she once... I'm sorry. I have tracking issues with my eyes right now. Anyway, she traveled around the world, then landed back in New Jersey back in 86. She first noticed interest in psychology after taking a human behavior course in high school.
Yes, sir.
Actually, that kind of interested me too, human behavior.
Mm-hmm. Good stuff.
You kind of figure out what your parents are talking about.
I got excited about when I saw Criminal Minds. That's how I got into
there,
it.
Yeah. That's all these SVUs. Show.
Yeah.
I've tried to defend myself in court with Law and Order, but that did not work too well. When they ask you if you want a lawyer, say yes, not don't represent yourself like me.
Yeah, don't do that.
Yeah.
I just say yes, and then I'd like to drop the case.
Trial by jury. Yeah. She graduated with an undergraduate degree in psychology from James Madison University.
Oh,
pretty
That's
fancy.
Right.
It's not the Sally Struthers Correspondence School. Mm-hmm. She also worked in state mental health hospitals afterwards for pre-adolescent teenage kids.
Oh, wow.
She moved to Charlotte here in 2000, the Queen City, and she went and got her master's degree from Gardner Webb here in Bowling Springs, North Carolina. 2006, she married her husband, and she has her license in professional counseling. Amongst other things, she's got so many little abbreviations at the end of her name. But she also started her private practice in 2014. She also does energy psychology, and I want to hear some about that because it's actually kind of a new thing to me. And I believe there's multifaceted ways to heal the body and mind, and that definitely intrigues me. So, and I think we've talked a little bit about energy personally. But so, Megan, welcome to the show, and welcome
Thank
back
you.
To the show. And tell us a little bit about yourself. Any tidbits we may have missed here?
Well, let's see. I guess starting out, like you said, got interested in how human beings work, human behavior in high school, and taking that course. It's kind of like, well, what makes people tick? Why do they do the things that they do? Why do they think this way? Why do they feel this way? How it all creates a cycle of thoughts and feelings and then actions or behaviors that come next. And so that was always really fascinating to me. Because you hear of all these different diagnoses as a kid, like, oh, what if, you know, you have this, what does that actually mean? But I always wanted to know the why. I always had this curiosity about me about, you know, why is that happening? I never sat with just the answer. So I think that's kind of what started it for me.
Hmm. And Biggun, what you got? I know you had some questions lined up. Man, my brain just froze over
here. Wow, all right. So we're just going to make...
Just dry it, yeah.
So, yeah, we're talking about 2017, and this is the time of the year where everybody sets their goals, sets their New Year's resolutions, and really just kind of wants to, quote-unquote, buckle down and do it right this year, you know, right? So you hear that all the time. So maybe through that process, what are some things that people can do that might help them stick to their goals or might be some good steps for people to take in that process?
It's a good question because we all start the new year with these resolutions that we're going to do so much. And I think sometimes, I mean, goals are always good to shoot for. If you always have your vision, it's just a matter of deciding that you will get there at some point and keep taking steps forward despite taking steps back at times. But if we decide we're going to do something, we set our intention, you know, as we wake up and as we go about our day and as we go on day to day with that same intention. you know, sometimes we'll tend to sit back and kind of look at what's happening in our life. And why is this happening to me? Why am I always broke? Why is nothing going right for me? And so, like, when you connect with the universe, this is kind of how energy psychology kicks in as well. You're kind of asking, you know, the universe can't decide, you know, if you're saying, how do I want things better? How can I do things better? It's just hearing that things are bad. And so the focus is, it's all bad. So if you're saying, I'm always broke, or why am I always broke? Well, your answers will become, because you're not doing what you, you know, all in a negative, no-win kind of fashion is what you get back. So it's more negativity. So your energy is then functioning at a lower vibration, if that makes any sense.
Okay. So just like you are what you eat, kind of like the thoughts that you think, kind of.
Yes.
Oh, that's a good one.
Yeah. Absolutely. Yeah. You can shape your day. Now, it's hard. It's hard work. It's very intentional. Very takes a very conscious effort each day. But the way you set your thoughts creates the feelings that you have, and you have thoughts and feelings that will then create actions that are either positive or negative. So depending on how you are going about your day and what you're consciously thinking, now knowing that there's only 5% of what you do comes from a conscious place, your subconscious kind of supersedes everything.
Really?
Is that a word? That's a word, right?
Oh, yeah. So wait.
Fit in there.
You're the college graduate here.
You got letters at the end of your name. You should know this.
You're the edumacated.
I try.
So you're saying that most of the stuff is, we're living like 5% consciously and then 95% subconsciously.
We are.
That's pretty interesting.
Is that just natural behaviors, instincts, things like that? Is that where the subconscious applies?
Well, it comes from all different kinds. You know, as you're shaped and as you're raised and the people that you're with, the environment that you're in, the things that you go through, it all shapes you. And we get to this place later on where we're responding to people certain ways and we think like, oh, well, you know, I had this issue, but I worked really hard at it and I'm not angry anymore. And you may feel at a conscious level that you don't have this anger towards this person, but subconsciously you still have all this resentment and despair or whatever it is that's still lingering. So it's hard to always know how to access that stuff, but that's where energy psychology comes into play.
Well, explain energy psychology. Is this a new thought practice, or is this a new type of form of practice or specialty, or has it been around for a while?
Well, we call it, you know, the ancient Chinese medicine, acupuncture. It's like acupuncture for the mind, but without the needles, which is really cool.
I hate needles.
I like needles.
Do you?
Not so much. Mm. I don't like them. So, luckily, we don't have to use them.
I've got like 160 hours worth of tattoos on me, so
needles are okay. I got you that. But, okay.
So,
I've had acupuncture like 20 times, but come back. I'm sorry.
Can you just finish that thought?
Go ahead.
No. This is our show. No.
I am going to turn your mic off, by the way.
That's happened before.
Sorry, go ahead.
Won't be the first, won't be the last.
That's probably right.
So you're tapping into those energy meridians in your body, but without using the needles. So it's essentially a way of looking at either specific events in your life, overall feelings. You can look at bad habits that you want to change, leftover feelings from things that have happened in the past. And you're looking at not, you know, getting rid of memories, but kind of being able at the end of it to take the emotional, the guttural pull that you feel of negativity out of those events or out of those situations, out of your relationships with people by one, working through the details of what had happened prior. And so it's ideally in the end, you're looking at like a storybook of your life, being able to just say, okay, this is what happened and that wasn't pleasant, but I don't have that emotional struggle anymore. So it's not changing anything, it's not erasing anything, but it's helping to deal with the emotional piece that just doesn't ever feel good when you're dealing with something hard.
Well, I know that actually we're going to be honored to have hopefully your husband on to talk about another subject that's kind of dear to my heart, but I know that a lot of times what you're talking about, people that can't cope will also lead into like addiction and vices and things like that, that try to mask the pain. So this energy psychology, I'm really kind of digging it, because I mean, we're all energy matter. I don't want to get too fruitcakey here, but I mean, just with the heart and stuff, you know, that's all I can think of, the neurons and stuff that fire the heart. And I mean, we have electric neurons and stuff in our brain. I mean, every organ has, you know, some type of electrical pulsation or energy field. So stuff like this, I find it fascinating.
So what are some things that if somebody wants to come and have some sessions with you, like what are some of the common things that you deal with or that you work on?
Where do I begin? It's really It's really, each person's unique. There's not a set pattern that I follow, but anybody coming in with relationship struggles, because that's a wide range. Mm-hmm. That's with partners, that's with kids, that's with parents, that's with, you know, neighbors, friends. It's relationships is very general. I can speak for a lot. So any of that, any bad habits that, you know, you mentioned addictions. I work with a lot of people who struggle with eating, whether it's under eating, overeating, struggling with that and using that, as you said, coping with their pain instead of feeling their emotions. So those that get stuck in not feeling, that have been numbed out, they've had so much trauma, they've had so much pain, they've kind of numbed themselves, and then they sit in a life of depression and just feeling like they can't feel, or the only feeling they can feel is sadness or despair and loneliness. So it really, a lot of anxiety, and that comes in all forms, specific fears. A lot of people come in with, you know, panic attacks that they're having often. And energy work works really good on that.
Okay.
So, yeah, wide range.
Yeah, sounds like it. So somebody that, you know, starts 2016, has a lot of stress. Are there any, like, practical steps for people that have stress that they can, like, or how do you relieve stress? Maybe that's a good question.
Mindfulness practices. With this busy world, we are so focused on our phones, focused on our work, focused on running the kids here and there, and we don't take time for ourselves. Mm-hmm. And we hear all about self-care, and we need to, right. We need to do it, but who actually does it? We stay busy.
Right.
We prefer to be busy. It's like we've just, it's like the new thing. Not that it's new anymore, but we just do it without even thinking. So it takes a very conscious, intentional effort to sit down and say, hey, I'm going to take some time to myself, whether that's just having a blank space. You had mentioned earlier about having no noise and just nothingness.
Yeah.
And it can be amazing. And to some people, that makes them very uncomfortable.
Right.
They're just not used to it. So it's kind of like, well, then maybe all my feelings will come back if I sit in the nothingness, and I don't want to deal with that. So I'm just going to stay busy. Meditation practices, we go through different ways of you know, teaching mindfulness and different little tools and meditations that they can take and use each day. De-stressing is, you know, it takes a consistency. It's not something that you can, hey, I'm gonna, you know, gonna go do some yoga tomorrow and I'll be fixed. It's a process.
Right.
You know, I always say counseling is a journey. It's not a quick fix. And I have to remind myself of that sometimes, because I do get excited when people make progress. But each person is unique and moves at their own pace. And some need to go back 5 steps before they can come forward. And so you just got to sit with each person and see, you know, what they really need. Step with them.
Yeah.
It's all about the relationship too. I mean, that's so important. And, a counseling, it's a team, you know, it's a team effort. So I'm just their guide. They're the lead.
So what's been through this journey? Cause you've started like your own business and doing that. So what's been maybe the hardest thing that you've dealt with going into starting your business and talking with folks?
All right. Yeah. Also maybe why did you start your own practice too? Instead of working part of the state? I just want to I think it's kind of a two part question, but why did you start your private practice too? Okay, and resume, because I know that you did the state level stuff for a while. So,
well, there's a lot of rules and red tape to follow with the state.
Always short on funds too, I'm sure.
Always short on funds. Know it. So that was a big one. Having kids was another big one. I wanted to be able to work around my schedule and be able to be flexible, which has been awesome. And really being able to focus in on the stuff that feels good to me, still obviously following the legal guidelines of my of state licensing board, but just having some more flexibility into how I do things, you know, and working with the different clients. Before, I was working a lot with families. I was doing intensive in-home services, which is just families that need a lot of help. They're really struggling, and it's a family effort. Although I learned a lot, just wasn't the best space for me. And so I kind of struggled with that for a while and thought maybe I wasn't in, you know, wasn't in the right field. Even though, you know, I had always felt called to, you know, do this line of work. And my husband, who's also, as you said, in the field, a little bit different, but very similar. He said, you know, it's just not the right job. You're just not doing what you want to do. You know, why don't you join all your passions together, which fitness and exercise and nutrition has always been a big one as well. And I was kind of like, oh, well, yeah, that makes sense. Hey, why don't I put it all together? And so my focus is on complete wellness. You know, you're only as well as a part of you. So you put all the parts together and you make your whole, but you get a different kind of whole in you if you don't have all your parts working effectively. So you work on the nutrition, what you're feeding your body, the exercise that keeps you going, which also is great for anxiety, depression. It's like the best all natural mood stabilizer or mood enhancer that there is. And, and then working on your mind. So the whole mind body thing is kind of where I put my energy.
Very cool. Yeah. I forgot who it was that we had a guest, and they were saying you got to treat your body just as much as you treat your soul and work on all of those things together. So
I think it's kind of been an underlying theme. I know Dr. CJ mentioned that, and also our fitness guy, Dave Bennard, who just came on. So speaking of the food, so you're a certified fitness nutrition specialist, so that's a kind of a mouthful there. But I cheat all the time, so I'm not going to even lie.
We all do. It's okay.
But but I know that you are what you eat, and if someone goes constantly eats at a 24-hour drive-through, pretty much every day of the week, they're going to feel like that 24-hour drive-through dumpster at the end of the week. So, the nutrition component of this. What would you because our cells. The energy, is dependent upon the food that we intake. So what are some type of diets, some type of foods that you kind of recommend? And on a sidebar, I know we've talked about doing something together as far as food and nutrition, but what are some things that you would highly suggest that put people to or like good mood food? I've heard that term 100,000 times, good mood food. So what are some good mood foods just to kind of help people get the day started and just kind of run throughout the day?
Or is there any diet that just involves eating only biscuits and gravy?
There is a diet. It's called the biscuit and gravy diet. I'll try that.
It's called the field terrible diet.
Side note, there is a Dr. Pepper Vienna sausage diet, by the way.
Is there really?
Yeah, you just eat Vienna sausage gracious. And drink Dr. Pepper. Yeah.
Until your cholesterol and blood pressure and
all that. Yeah, but I think you lose weight, but you're in a casket like shortly after.
Sounds like a good solution.
Well, I guess you technically are losing all that weight.
Well, you leave a beautiful corpse, I guess. I don't know.
Sorry.
You're fine. Mood food. So I'd never heard that. Yeah, you got me a little stumped. Blueberries. They're pretty and yummy. And
if you bounce a basketball at the same time. You're onto something there.
There's that too. No,
shout out to Mason.
Shout out to my youngin. No, you. But yeah, put it with some Greek yogurt. Put some granola in there, and we're looking at there's different types of that. A healthier granola. You want the fewer the ingredients on the packages. That's a good way to do it. You can have oatmeal, and then you can have oatmeal. If you look and there's like three ingredients, it's a good oatmeal. If you look at it and you can't pronounce the stuff in the ingredients list, don't buy it.
Sounds like a pharmaceutical chemistry test.
Yeah, my daughter tried to pronounce it the other day. I'm like, just stop. Not at our house. At the store.
Wash your mouth out, was it?
I think she just said a dirty word.
How about there's in the world of nutrition or holistic, you have things like cell foods, like the blueberries would be a cell food, the omega acids or omega fatty acids will be cell food. Greens like chlorella, spirulina. Do you have any?
Hey, you're good.
What?
Look at that.
Yeah. Any of the kelps. What's that?
Gravy.
Has to be green.
It does start with a G, so you get GR, so you're close. All right. So, do you recommend taking supplements and stuff at your practice, or?
I mean, I do, but again, I'm not solely focused on nutrition, so I kind of blend in with what I'm doing. I mean, like fish oil helps for inflammation in the body, so it is turmeric, which is another ingredient that's awesome. Yeah. But fish oil also helps with clarity if you struggle with ADHD and with focus. And
I need some extra today.
Take a double dose.
Good.
Nothing wrong with that.
It's also good for the heart too.
It's good.
Yeah,
I was getting there.
I'm sorry. Why do we have a yawn?
No, I'm glad you're so informed.
It doesn't help your breath though.
That's true.
Well, you take the decent kind. that you don't burp up, because those are gross. So there's a little test you can do. I always recommend Nordic Naturals. It's a little bit more expensive.
Just the one I take.
Awesome. If you take a, I'm not gonna say names of those that are not good, but you try it, you know, if you have some, stick it in the freezer for a minute or two. If it turns cloudy, it's got a lot of junk in there. That's how you know.
I'll say it's the major stain, the major stores, like the chain stores, like the usually have a pharmacy attached. Mm-hmm. There's actually reports that actually come out and said that the product in their product is actually not the product they're selling. So you may go for fish oil and get like wood dust. So yeah,
like olive oil that came out for a while.
There's an olive oil cartel. That's right. Yeah, but yeah, so you know, like she said, anytime you, and I can tell you this. I mean, I used to own a health food store. So look for the better quality ingredient or the better quality brands, not the ones that you'd go see like something made or something Puritans, whatever Pride. I mean, they're just not good.
You're wasting good your money.
Yeah, you might as well just eat the bottle that came in instead of the product inside of it. Probably get better results. So,
So let me ask you this, going back to like, what's the hardest thing? Cause we didn't go back to that question. Sorry. So what's the hardest thing that you had to overcome or even like learn through this experience of either starting your business or dealing with a client or something like that? That's been hard.
Well, hardest, I think part of that was when I thought that maybe this wasn't what I was supposed to do, but I was just in the wrong area of what I was doing. And so that I was able to fix that. Took a few years off. My kids were little. First child was born and took some time off. So came back. And I think, I don't know, when you can't fix everybody, and nor is that my job to fix somebody. Yeah. It's to teach people and to educate them and help them gain awareness and to take on new practices of what's going to benefit them, all that kind of stuff. You know, for me, I can get caught up in, you know, I've always struggled with not having enough patience. So I've learned that, but I've had to learn that through the process of being with people, that presence. And not like, okay, because I'm kind of like a feel your fear and do it anyway kind of person. I don't sit with how am I going to do that. I question a lot, but not when it comes to this stuff. I'm like, you know what? If it scares me, I'm doing it. Like, where? Wow. Tell me where. And that's just kind of the mentality. But again, that's kind of, that comes from my upbringing and feeling like I had to do a lot on my own. And so I kind of instilled that if I'm going to get it done, it's going to be me. And so let's just go ahead and jump over the hurdle and do it. So I've had to learn to kind of step back and be patient with people. And you know, I learned something new from everybody, which is really cool because everybody who comes in is different.
Yeah. What's been the best part that you've experienced?
Oh, gosh. There's so many. I get just as much out of this as other people. You know, people will come in and they're so appreciative and, you know, thanks for working with me. We've made such a difference. And it's like I selfishly can take just as much from helping someone because it feels good. I mean, my passion lies in helping other people. So, you know, I had a girl, she's pretty new, but I'm just thinking of today, the people that came in and said, you know, over the holidays, I hadn't seen her in 2 weeks. But prior to that, she was having panic attacks just about every day. And she was like, yep, I haven't had one in 2 weeks.
Wow.
I think fulfilling your call in life is very, you know, it can be personally rewarding, I think. So,
absolutely.
Very cool.
Where do you see, I'm just kind of curious in the psychology field, where do you see, I mean, psychology is a fairly new, you know, form of medicine, I guess you'd call it that, but where do you think psychology is going to morph into? Because, I mean, in the next few years, I mean, you see a lot of people incorporating more than just the sitting there on the couch and talking to someone with a smelly leisure suit and glasses and taking notes? Or, I mean, is it going to be more that's encompassing kind of a holistic approach where energy, diet, things like that? Do you see psychology moving in that direction?
I sure hope so. I mean, that's what's it. Yeah. That's where it's headed. You know, the first pharmaceutical companies out there, they want to keep you thinking somewhere else. And the doctors, you know, they're trained in push medicine. And there's some more holistic schools that have come about.
Yeah.
And you know, you hear the push from them as well that, hey, this is what works. This is what we should have been doing long ago. They were doing this, you know, many, many, many years ago.
Yeah.
Why are we trying to change and pump people full of all this stuff that, that their bodies don't actually need?
Right.
Let's just do what nature intended and eat right and get your exercise. You know, back in the days, they were running from the animals that were chasing them. They got their exercise, you know, and they ate organically. And
yeah. And we've talked about it on the show, like our grandparents, like their food was actually different than our food. You know,
oh, absolutely.
Like, you know, bacon was different back then. And people were plowing fields the whole time.
Mm-hmm. Well, I think just also, I mean, because, you know, I'm a conspiracy theorist, but it's no lie, though, that, you know, you have just a couple companies that produce all the seed in the world, and they all have patents on the seed.
Yeah.
I don't know how you can patent nature, but, you know, there you go. So the same seed we're using for corn nowadays is not the same seed they used for corn even 50 years ago.
Yeah.
So, and of course, corn is in our diet almost everywhere. Corn syrup, corn pie. I mean, you know what I'm saying? So definitely the food that we're eating now, I mean, it's just it's nothing comparable to what, you know, our grandfathers or even before them even had. So I agree. And of course, you know, a lot of those old people, I mean, you know, we lived to 110, you know, smoking two packs a day. And now we got people clocking out pretty early, you know. But I think diet, I mean, like I said, you are what you eat. So I think it's huge. So by the way, I mean, just a side note, I know people will probably sometimes listen and they'll listen to this podcast. And of course, our opening part of the interview was this is by Energy of the Universe. Megan is a Christian. She goes to our church. So you, the old days of, you know, if it ain't in the Bible, then it's probably wrong. I mean, you know.
How about that tie that you're wearing on Sundays isn't in the Bible? Just saying.
Catch your beer, catch your corners. But also, I feel blessed. Megan's part of our circle you know, of people that we know. And I feel I feel like one of the luckiest people on earth that almost all the guests we've had on, exception of maybe one or two, have been in our immediate circle of people. We know so many amazing people, right?
Yeah,
I mean, definitely. And Megan's part of our home group. Her husband and family are, and also our church. And it's just, it's amazing. I mean, just the people that we know that have so much experience.
Yeah.
I feel kind of little sometimes, you know, but.
We've taken a lot from you, trust me.
what not to do? Yeah, there's a lot of
that. Well, there's that too.
There's a lot of that. But no, I just feel so blessed. You know, I mean, just kind of refreshing back to 2016. I mean, we've been here, what, you know, 6 months, seven months now. And just the you just, I mean, we've sat beside Megan, had, you know, broke bread with her many times, and to know that she knows all this stuff. And it's just amazing. You know, she's sitting right beside us the whole time, you know. And
just for I think
the
you're record, pretty cool too.
It's gluten-free bread, by the way. You know, it's gluten-free bread.
Gluten-free bread. Gluten, yeah. Gluten-free. Well, but no, it's just amazing, I think. So just a selfish side note there.
And my wife said this show should actually be called Getting to Know One Life Church.
Pretty much. I think, but
we're
you know,
break out.
For such a small church that we go to,
we
got some pretty awesome people. So, so maybe our church is better than yours. I probably shouldn't say that. but no, I mean, I feel blessed and that to know so many strong people. So it's pretty amazing.
Yeah. Anything else?
Probably so many questions, but I'm sure she's got to get home.
Yeah.
So.
I'm on your time now.
Well, we're going to go to the segment called 10 in 1. So we're going to ask you 10 questions in under 1 minute to see if you can do it. And so, Mojo, go ahead and start the clock. Oh, are you ready for this?
Do I get a choice? Go ahead.
Nope.
Shoot.
We didn't tell you about this part, so.
All right, so here we go. In 1 minute, what's your favorite TV show?
Oh, This Is Us. Easy.
All right, fruit or vegetable?
Shout out to Jess. She's with me. depends. Fruit.
Best Christmas gift ever?
For my kids? They're real little handwritten notes there.
All right. Yoga pants or leggings?
Leggings.
Favorite season of the year?
Spring.
Mind over matter or matter of fact?
Mind over matter.
HDTV or HDTV?
HDTV.
2016 was blank. You fill it in.
Pretty cool.
Stairmaster or Thighmaster?
Oh, Lord have mercy. None.
And what's your spirit food?
Spirit food. Pasta?
Okay. There you go. She got it in under a minute.
Love the carbs.
Right. Very we all cool. do.
Well, thanks for being on the show. I really appreciate it.
Oh, absolutely. My
if
pleasure.
People, if people want to get to know you or get in touch with you to get some help, how do they do that?
They can contact me on my website. I've got a connection there. They can get to my Facebook page, and they can contact me on there. It shows how to get a hold of me. So, which is www.wellnesssolutions. There's three S's there in the middle. WellnessSolutionsPLLC.com.
Dropping the extra S's.
You can also, she'll be on our website, so we'll have a link out there in show notes.
Yeah, we'll put it on the Facebooks.
On the Facebooks, yep. Very cool. Well,
good deal.
Anything else?
No, just looking forward to 2017 being productive and just another awesome year.
Yes, sir.
Every day you wake up is a great day. So, anyway, thanks for listening. Please go back on Facebook and check us out at Southern Fried Philosophy, Instagram and Twitter at SFP Radio, and our official website at www.southernfriedphilosophy.com.
All right. Well, thanks as always for tuning in. And by the way, shout out to the person who's listening in Hungary. Listen to every
episode. In China. China.
It's crazy. Yeah. We're blowing up. We're global. All right.
International.
Thanks, everybody. And as always, keep it rolling. Did you know it take 47. Did you know it takes a customer 3 seconds to decide whether to stay on or leave your website? That's why a crisp, clean, and user-friendly website is one of the best ways to market and help your and grow your business. Webmerize Web Design offers that and much more. They pride themselves in offering our clients professional websites at amazingly affordable prices. Are you a small business? No problem. They cater to small businesses by working with our clients every step of the way to help grow their businesses by successfully website development. Nope. Check them out at webmerize.com or on the sponsor section of the Southern Fried Philosophy website.
For only 64 cents a day, you can adopt Mojo for his sushi addiction.
What's that on the ad?
Just kidding. It's like the Sarah McLachlan.
Yeah.